Hello friends, this is Mainak from Civil Center and I welcome all of you back to our channel. So as you can see, we are in front of a total station here. So as you had seen in our earlier videos, total station is basically a combination of EDM, that is electronic distance measurement, and theodolite. So it measures distances at high accuracy. Also we can get the x, y, z coordinates of a point, that is we can get the easting, northing and elevation. So in this video tutorial series, we'll see how to operate a total station. So let's get started. So friends, this is my colleague Nibaran Paria. He will operate the total station for you. So as you can see, these are the three tripods of the total station. Now the first thing we need to do is, we have a point here. As you can see, this is a point which we need to center. So the first step is the centering of the total station. So for the centering, we need to adjust our total station and view the mark with the help of this optical plummet. As you can see, he is viewing this center mark with the help of this optical plummet. It should come at the center so that the instrument has been centered properly. So after the centering, we'll do the leveling of the total station. Now we'll find out how to level our total station using these three foot screws. So first we'll switch on our machine. So as you can see, our machine is being switched on. So after our machine has been switched on, we will level the machine with the help of our foot screws. So as you can see, we have a circle here and the center we have a bubble. So this bubble need to be adjusted so that it is at the center. So as you can see, our operator is using the foot screws to increase the accuracy of the bubble. Now you can see it is almost at the center. So after the minutes and seconds are minimized, we can say that the instrument has been leveled. Now after leveling of the instrument, we'll proceed further to take our readings.
So before starting any new work, we need to create a new job in our total station. So this is how our total station screen looks like. So first we'll go to the option of data, and that is in F3. So we'll press F3 for the data, and then as you can see, we have the options of job, known data and code. So first we'll select the option of job and then we'll press enter. The job is selected and we pressed enter. So now we have the option of job selection, job details, and we have other options. So first we'll go to our option of job selection, enter. Now as you can see, there is an option of job selection and coordinate search job. So the one thing to be noted here is that the job selection and the coordinate search job both should be the same. So we can go to our list option, which is under the option of F1. So we'll press F1 for the list, and you can see the list of jobs. So as you can see, the job 19, job 20, Friday, all are empty. So we'll just select the job 19, and in the coordinate job option also, we'll go to list, and then after the list appears, we'll also select job 19, because in both these jobs, that is the job selection and the coordinate search job, we need to have the same option. So now we'll press enter, and then next we'll go to our job details. After going to our job details, we'll press enter, and then as you can see, the job name is job 19. You can change this job name here, which is like editing the name of the job using this keys. So we can name it as XYZ, and the scale will keep as 1. So we can now press OK using the F4 option. Now as you can see that our machine is ready for the work to be started. So friends, how did you find this video? Please let us know in our comment section, and if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, please hit the subscribe button. And if you want offline training from us, and if you want to join our Civil Center Student Club, contact 9777-46-9666, where you give industrial training to civil engineering students and professionals. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.